Dom, thank you so much for joining us. First time we've had you on the show this split, but I want to come right to you. How have you been enjoying the Mid-Season Showdown so far?
Well, to be honest, you know, these two teams are the two teams that we've been waiting for all year. All the other teams are pretty trash, and here we are.
Round three of the Mid-Season Showdown is complete. You know what that means? It's time for the VENN Esports LCS Awards. You saw the games this weekend. Cloud9 took down Team Liquid, and 100 Thieves fell to TSM. But let's take a look at some of the top plays and moments from this last weekend's action. First up, the top 10 Huni made betrayals goes to, well, you can imagine it, TSM Huni for blasting Spica over the wall and forcing him to flash back on over after he did all the work so that he wouldn't get destroyed by 100 Thieves.
Spica's got it ready to go. TSM have the Baron, and now the team fight started up. Sword Art's tanking on the front line. He will be the sacrifice. Spica jumps. Oh no! What in the hell?
It's been betrayed.
Oh, okay. We're gonna pretend like we didn't see that. We didn't see that.
Okay, we need to talk about this one. The Are There Any More Skill Shots to Miss award goes to the entirety of TSM and 100 Thieves. I mean, I guess you could call it a team fight, but either way, let's just count together how many skills were missed.
Who he finds his way here. Oh, and a nice ulti bringing Spica right back over to the AD carry, but now they gotta be careful. Sword Art's looking to lock everybody down. They wanna get Tristana away.
All right, one, shockwave, slow, ball, wall, flash, stun, no, axe miss, no. Axe did land on that one. Huni's still alive, axe miss, ball miss, oh, wall miss, power of evil dead.
I think we counted 9 for 10, 8, 9, or 10. I don't know how many it was. Did I miss any? Let us know in the comments below, and while you're there, hit subscribe, will you? Thanks. The You Gotta Toe the Company Line, Dude award goes to my man Dom for predicting against the team that pays him to stream. Look, man, I know you always talk your mind, but come on, dude. It's the first time you're back on the LCS broadcast. This is ridiculous. Take a look.
Dom, thank you so much for joining us. Before you leave, I'll be remiss if I let you go without getting your prediction. It's an early one, but we'll have to wait for these three. But who are you thinking is going to take it? Cloud9, TL, first team to the finals.
Okay, so first off, Jack, please do not fire me for giving this prediction.
Oh no!
I am a Cloud9 server, but I do think, and this is my brain talking, not my heart, I do think it's going to be a 3-2. For TL. I think it's gonna be close, but I think TL might have the advantage of this one.
Of course, Cloud9 showed they were ready to make Dom look silly. So here's the We Heard That award going to Cloud9 bot lane duo Sven and Vulcan for taking care of business early into the game and starting off 2-0 in game number one.
So push out your side lanes, then contract again towards mid to get this outer done. They do have some setup on Dragon.
Here we go. Fear comes across. Blabber going to find himself a single root in the stun as well. Centaurin cannot survive. And Fudge Stride breaks four. Gets a single stun. Charm hits only one champion. And the tower dive comes in for Cloud9. 2-0 to start. Cannot quite find the Razz. True Shot Barrage nearly lands thanks to perks. But Blabber is still on the hunt. Can he find the skill shots? Not just yet. They're going to take down mid lane outer turret just like they wanted to all along.
Continuing on the path of making Dom's prediction look dumb, the Don't Question Perks award goes to, well, it's Perks for his quadra kill on Ryze. And yes, his Ryze is bad, but NA's worse. You guessed it right. It's Cloud9 Perks.
He's on ward. Sven's gonna slow him down. Here comes the pull to the front line. Quarter Day not as easily saved, and now has to run away. Dive in the back line is in, and is it gonna be enough damage? They try to knock down Sven, and he's surviving. Finally goes down the tactical, but that means he has to overextend. And Cloud9, they've still got Perks. Oh, baby, it's a quadra kill for the mid laner. And just like we saw a year and a half ago, Perks has taken down Team Liquid.
The NA can't possibly be that bad, can it? Award goes to Cloud9 and Team Liquid for this early game invade that resulted in not one, not two, actually two, but almost three deaths. This is ridiculous, right?
Yeah.
Ooh, Jensen? Oh, this is a little bit of danger. I mean, Tom Kench is here, but with Ash slows the dash in, I mean, Jensen's landing phase is so doomed now. He's at 200 health, and he's got a flash! Perks on the flash chase! It's an early first blood! It's 120 in the game! Meanwhile, Fuck is going down as well! We got kills everywhere! We got a spicy game 4! First blood saves lives!
Oh, no!
He's actually just dead! Jeez, what a game!
And here's the Stay Classy LCS award going to my friend of Venn, and the LCS host, one of the best hosts in the world, James Dash Patterson, for getting Ron Burgundy'd by reading exactly what's in the prompter for his birthday.
Starting at 1 p.m. on Sunday. All that's left to say, though, is from all of us behind the scenes here at the LCS, happy birthday, Dash. Why do you have to put that in the prompter? You know I'm gonna read it.
Happy birthday, brother.
Hey, thanks for watching VENN Esports. Make sure to hit that subscribe button below and explore other videos. In fact, click on the ones on the screen right now. This one, and this one.